Alright guys, welcome back again to the Remoraid Only Run, and we're here in Blackthorn. We're not in Blackthorn, we're in Mahogany, and we're gonna take on the Ice Gym. And yeah, there's a lot of like seals and dugongs here. So like Psybeam and Surf are my strongest options against them, which isn't the best of news, but in the end it's not too problematic because they can't do much to hit me back, so it's all good in the hood. So yeah, we don't want evolution, and yeah, we'll see how fast I can solve the puzzle once I've battled all the trainers, because I know that in Diamond Pearl Plat I hated the Ice Gym. When I first played through Pearl, like just playing through it, before I even got into online battling, I was so stuck on that Ice Gym trying to figure it out. But because I'm cool like that, and I don't really like puzzles. Though I say that, games like Professor Layton and The Curious Village are one of the best DS games out there. Get it. Amazing. Anyway, yeah, so like whiz around here, and wait a minute, if I step right there I can get in front of Pryce already. I just unintentionally solved the gym puzzle there, which will save me a fair bit of time there. I did not even intend to do that. And yeah, Shellders and Cloisters have poor special defense, which is good. And yeah, I could have got straight to him then. It's quite a winding path to get to these two gym trainers, but we're gonna do it for the experience. So hopefully we can just sneak into level 48 before the gym, so if we can sneak in there, that'd be good. As long as this last person has like two pokes or something like that. And our luck, obviously, she only has the one poke, which means I will fall just short of the level at statistic. But anyway, we'll heal up and then we'll go and take on Pryce. So I almost healed up twice then. Yeah, so I went up, round, all the way back down. Yeah. So yeah, we gotta take on Pryce. And Pokémon have experiences and stuff. He's my elder. But yeah, I find Pryce is quite offensive. Not in terms of battling, just in terms of who he is. Thinks he's all that because he's old and experienced. And Icy wins, speed drop. No, still faster. And there's the level up. And Dewgong. My 3-hit KO that. Come on. Yeah, that's a 3-hit KO. And lastly, we got Pillar Swine, which Regieleaguers, remember, Pillar Swine is not Hoenn. That's important to remember. And yeah, that's Pryce. Pryce is pretty simple. Admittedly. Just because I have Surf that can hit Pillar Swine. And we get Icy Wind, which is useless because we have the Ice Beams. And Helm calls you when you leave the gym, and he tells you about the weird radio signals. And if you go into your poker, whatever it's called in this game, nav, is it a nav? No, it's a poker gear. If you go in there, you can like see that Rocket, Team Rocket, are making radio broadcasts, but first things first, I'm gonna clear some space in my inventory by selling some goods here at the department store. what to get rid of. I think I get rid of the protein and the nugget, which will get me almost 10,000 between them. And this is a idea. I can throw away the berry. I'm never gonna use it, so yeah. And now we've got Surf, it's worth coming back here for two reasons. The first is because I think if you defeat these three trainers here, they give you something like Stardust, which sells quite well in the shops. And also it's a little bit of experience, obviously. So yeah. And we get Seeking.
Right.
I swear, like, this, that silver sprite there, it just looks like a big goldfish. Really did look like a big goldfish. And it's Staryu, which means they're gonna have Starmie, which means it's gonna be a problem. I don't like you anymore. But they'll probably have retarded AI. Bubble Beam. I can show you my Bubble Beams as well.
Rawr.
And lastly, we face this one, Kate, who is meant to be the strongest of the three, but I think she's the worst of the three because Shellder. Shellder and Cloyster are apparently better than Staryu, Starmie, or Goldene Seeking, which is just false facts, really, isn't it? And yeah. So we defeat her, and we don't want John Joe to evolve, and there's no item. We have to speak to them. Yeah. Soft Sand. Don't really know what Soft Sand does, but oh well. And now this is me searching for a tentacle. Here we go. Bubble Beam. Please survive it. Or don't survive it. Is there any chance of a higher 21 tentacle? Can you survive a Bubble Beam? Yes. And we can throw. That's only for a Pokemon with a rod. But normally, just throw a Pokeball. Because we got the skills, we can catch them in the Pokeball just like that. And yeah, there's our Whirlpool user. Caught. And we just need to teach him now. Whirlpool, Tentacool, Hit with Supersonic. I don't know why I was being selective there with what move I got rid of, because it doesn't matter at all, because Tentacool's never going to be sent out in a battle. And yeah, that is that for now. I never got why they put that rocket there to block off, because you can get in the underground up here anyway, so it's a pretty irrelevant thing. That bit's completely blocked off, there's nothing of use there that they're actually blocking off anyway, so it doesn't really matter. And here we are at the radio tower where Rocket have taken over, and next episode we will enter and take on those villains.